To my left, to your right, so we can all kind of fit in this room. And if you come closer to the coil, no reason to be afraid. Fine. Just gotta move a bit more to the left because of crowds. Right. So this behind me is a Tesla coil or a Tesla transformer. I told you a bit about transformers when I talked about the power plant. So they transform various properties of currents, and Tesla coils transform voltage and frequency of alternating currents, and this one in particular transforms the 220 volt voltage into a half a million volts and a 50 hertz frequency into about a million or 1 megahertz frequency. So how do they transform the voltage? Well, there's a lot going on, but in essence, all we need are two coils. So here we have this one on the outside, it kind of looks like a fence, it's actually a coil. I know that these don't quite look like wires, they're a bit thick and square, but they are wires, and again, coils are just wraps of wire in a cylinder. So that's our primary coil, and here inside we have a secondary coil, which looks much more like a coil. You can see these are more obviously wires, they're much thinner, much more densely packed. And most important of all, the number of individual wraps of wire around the secondary is much larger than on the primary. Now, when I talked about the motor, I mentioned that if you have a coil and alternating current flowing through it, you'll get an electromagnetic field around the coil. And when I talked about the power plant, I mentioned that the inverse was true as well. If you have a coil inside such a field, it'll start inducing some alternating current. So what happens is the current flows through the primary, which creates its own field, but as the secondary is inside the primary's field, the current will be induced from the primary into the secondary. Now, the voltage in the secondary will be much larger because, as I mentioned, the number of individual wraps of wire around the secondary is much bigger, and the ratio of the number of wraps on the secondary and the primary dictates the ratio of the difference in voltage as well. So the bigger the difference in the number of wraps, the bigger the transformation of the current. Of course, as the voltage goes up, it's transformed into higher voltage, the intensity, the amperage of the current is lower, so we get a weaker current, but of a much higher voltage. So, when I turn the machine on, the voltage in the secondary will reach half a million volts, and the difference in voltage between the coil and the wall above it, which is the grounding, where there is zero voltage, will cause an electrical discharge between those two, because the current is very lazy, it wants to go to a place of lower voltage as quick as possible, ideally to the ground, and that's why we'll again get the electrical discharge in the form of a lightning bolt. Now at that point we'll be surrounded by the electromagnetic field of the coil, and the conductors inside the area will start conducting current. So again, current will be induced in these conductors. And among those conductors will be we ourselves as well. You might be wondering if that's completely safe or not. I assure you that it is. You're not the first nor the last to come here, so I'm sure you're all going to be fine. I'm going to explain a bit later why it's the case. For now, I just ask you to trust me on this one. I hope that's going to be enough. So, to prove that, to prove that the conductors in the area are indeed conducting currents, I'm going to hand you a couple of these conductors in the form of these lamps, which will of course light up when I turn the machine on. So, I'm using a couple here, four lamps. Unfortunately, we don't have enough lamps for everyone. If we did, I'm not sure where we would put all of these, so it is what it is. Alright, so before we begin, I have to ask if any of you have a pacemaker. Have any of you a pacemaker? No pacemakers? Alright. And you lamps, maybe come even a bit closer. You can maybe just spread out like along the fence. closer you are to the source of the field, the brighter they will look. So just try to hold lamps behind the fence, so like we're doing now. And don't lean them too much toward the coil. Try to hold them straight upwards. So, like, straight upwards. Because again, I told you the current wants to go to the nearest grounding. If your lamp is the nearest grounding, well, then the lightning will hit the lamp, which we don't want to happen. Mostly you don't want to happen. So try to hold them like this, and everything will be fine. So I'll turn the machine on a couple of times, and I'll count to three each time I turn it on. Keep in mind, it's the machine is a bit noisy. It's very loud actually, so just keep that in mind.
Where's that man?
Here we go.